All opinions expressed by the Raw Report guests are solely their current opinions and do not reflect the opinions of the Raw Report. The Raw Report guests' opinions are based upon information they consider reliable, but neither the Raw Report or its affiliates warrant its completeness or accuracy, and it should not be relied upon as such.
You've worked all week and now the weekend is here. Relax time, or is it? Grass needs mowing, leaves need to be raked, or the snow needs to be shoveled. You know what? Enjoy your relaxed time and leave that work to Avalanche Landscaping. Whether it's snow removal, debris hauling, lawn mowing, plant digging, mulching, tree removal, tree cutting, whatever your landscaping needs are, let Avalanche be the company you go to. Fully insured and here for you. Pricing is negotiable and they're available anytime, servicing all of Connecticut and the tri-state area. Give Avalanche Landscaping your business and enjoy your time off from a hard week's work. For more information on Avalanche Landscaping, give them a call at 203-665-8470 or 203-535-1205 or 203-589-1677 or email them at avalanchesnow502@gmail.com. Avalanche Landscaping, servicing all your landscaping needs. Want to be the talk of the town this summer? Or do you want your hair to stand out amongst the rest? Then check out High Maintenance by Simone. High Maintenance by Simone offers 100% raw virgin hair. Top quality, no shedding, and no tangling. And with proper maintenance, your hair can last 12 months or more. All lengths and all styles for those summertime colors are also available. All closures, frontal, and lace wigs are also available with High Maintenance. And also ask for the 3-bundle deal. And always get the best price and quality when you shop with High Maintenance. Satisfaction guaranteed and 2-day shipping anywhere in the United States. Also ask about the High Maintenance 10% off code. Use the promo code HMBS and get 10% off. For more information, you can contact High Maintenance at 252-499-3267. Or check out High Maintenance on Facebook at Simone Yowens. Or check her out on Instagram at High Maintenance by Simone. High Maintenance by Simone hair, the best quality you can get, and 100% raw virgin hair. It's High Maintenance, baby. What's up, everybody? I won't say CP time tonight. I won't say CP time. I don't think he's on the CP time. Let me test my bombs. Make sure we got to make sure we got everything right because we got somebody exclusive here. I like it when exclusive people come through and visit the Raw Report. You can also check us out on the Raw Report Show at gmail.com. Check out our website. But bigger than all that, ladies and gentlemen, Mario Boone's in the house.
Thank you. I got the fake
claps and everything for you, brother. What's going on?
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So, I'm glad you're here. I haven't seen you. A lot of people that don't know, this is Mario's third time up here.
Yeah.
He's a frequent here. He's a friend to the room. He's here tonight. He was saying he got a special announcement. I don't know what it is. We're gonna delve into that in a minute. But how you been, my brother?
I've been good. Working hard.
Okay.
Tired.
We see you. We definitely see you all over the television. You know.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
You know.
Yeah, but I'm good. I'm doing well. I can't complain at all. Just you know, just a little tired. But you know, that's part of life.
That's part of life. Part of the game. Now you're still on at night.
So my schedule has changed. I'm back on in the evenings now.
In the evenings now.
It's 5 and 6 p.m.
Okay. But other than that, everything's been good, working hard.
Just working hard, you know, just trying to stay on top of the news and trying to break stories every day and trying to, you know, keep my people informed.
How is the news these days?
It's heavy.
It's heavy.
It's real heavy. It's
heavy. How is the Mario Boone fan club? Has your haters, since the last time you've been here, has your haters stepped up a bit?
You know, I don't know because I don't really pay attention to the haters. So okay. I guess they're still out there. I mean, I do get the occasional hate mail or
okay.
hate tweet. But most of the time, I just delete that stuff. I don't even read it. So I guess they're out there.
Does that ever like bother you?
Nah.
Like as far as like hurt your feelings? Like can somebody say something online to hurt your feelings?
People do say things that are hurtful. Yes, you know, words do hurt. But I think I've learned how to handle it now, and I have very thick skin, so not a lot gets to me.
Right.
It takes a lot to get to me. But that's a rare thing for it to get to me.
For it to get to you, okay. Yeah. Do you?
I will say I am bothered by people who question my blackness. That bothers me.
I was, you know what? You must have read my
mind. Because I do get those comments a lot. You know, I don't like the. I won't give any life to some of the things they actually say.
Right.
But when people question my blackness, I don't like that.
Now, let me ask you this: is your blackness questioned by other black people
yes.
or white people?
No,
it's mostly black people.
It's only black people.
It's only black people.
Yes,
and that's a problem.
I don't like it.
Right.
I just don't. But people can say whatever they want. I don't. You know, I would never try to censor anybody, unless of course you're coming on my page.
Right. Now, do you think that it's that's easy for them? Now, do you think if you was a white man that would happen?
Probably so. People just like to criticize. You know, they don't care.
Right.
They don't care who it is.
Okay, they just like, because they...
People like to criticize, yeah. And it's and everybody, in this day and age, everybody is a journalist. They haven't been to nobody's journalism school. They've never had any formal training on how to be a journalist, but they know how to tell me how to be a journalist. So, you know, it's whatever.
I mean, they know how to tell you how to do your job.
Yeah, and I have to remind people a lot. Even, you know, there's some... there are a lot of people who like to tell me how to be a journalist, and I have to remind them, stay in your lane.
Now, do they do that online? Or
online. And some people have done it face-to-face. But, you know, look, I don't mind telling people, stay in your lane.
Stay in your lane.
Yes.
If you fly with chicken, flour your chicken.
Yeah, because I'm not going to ever come and tell you how to do what you do.
Right.
You know, if you're an expert in whatever, shoveling snow, I'm not going to try to tell you how to shovel snow because I don't know how to do that.
Right.
So I do what I know how to do, what I've been trained to do. And I'll let you do what you do.
Now, you said it's mostly black people that come at you.
Oh, when it comes to questioning my blackness.
Questioning your blackness.
In terms of overall criticism, I mean, that comes from all walks of life. You know?
Now,
that's just part of the job.
I got to ask you, have you heard the rumor about you sleeping with the pastor's wife? Let me hit him in the back again. Did you hear that one?
I did.
You did hear it.
It was hilarious.
I did see it online. I said, whoa, what the hell? What the hell is Boone doing out here?
But you know, that's not my thing. So
Right. I'm like, what is Boone doing in these streets? Boone is funny. That's his wife. When you saw it, did it make you laugh?
I did chuckle. Yes.
Okay. Oh, no, he didn't say he laughed. He said he chuckled. Oh, all right, that's cool though. I'm glad you laughed it off.
Because, yeah, I did.
But I told you before that you was a big deal. You was a celebrity.
Well, and you always say
I'm not a celebrity.
I'm just a regular person. You know, people run into me all the time at the grocery store. You know, I like to go to Target, but lately I've been forced to go to Walmart. And
why you been forced to go to Walmart?
Because Target is always out of what I need, so I have to.
Okay. You gotta go. So you're a regular dude.
I'm a regular person. I'm not no celebrity. And people, when they see me out, I always speak to folks, and you know, I'm in my most disguised outfits a lot of times.
Right.
Very incognito.
Uh-huh.
And people still spot me out. I was at the Big E last week, and I ran into quite a few people in New Haven.
Were they friendly?
Very friendly. Yeah.
Okay.
I came up and spoke. People took pictures. You know, I'm a friendly kind of person.
We got to get the rumors out. The other rumor is the Gucci is from the flea market.
I've personally not heard that, but
right. His Gucci is from the flea market, and you said you didn't even know what the flea market was.
I didn't.
Right.
And listen, people can think whatever they want to.
I'm
not here to dispel anybody's myth. If you feel like what I wear is from the flea market, then run with it.
Okay,
you know, what I wear is for me anyway. It ain't for nobody else.
Right.
You know,
right,
I dress for me. So I don't care what people think.
Right,
about where
I got
stuff
you.
From.
Yeah. So, with all that being said, the announcement.
Wait, was that all the rumors? Because I'm sure.
No, wait. I think. Wait, let me think. The preacher's wife, the Gucci, someone else's wife you supposedly slept with, and they were.
Let me just say this. Uh-oh. I can guarantee everybody, I'm not sleeping with nobody's wife. Now, first of all, I don't sleep with anybody who's married,
to my knowledge. Right, okay.
But if it was rumored to be somebody, it wouldn't be the wife. I'll just put it that way. Now, having said that, you know, I am still single.
Okay.
I am habitually single.
Okay.
And I, you know, it'd be nice to.
Habitually single?
Yeah, and it's not by choice. You know, it's getting cold. This is cuffing season.
Yeah,
I actually want to be cuffed, you know.
You want to be cuffed?
I do, yeah.
Okay, listen.
Just in time for the winter. I would love to have a special.
So what about when springtime, are you trying to uncuff?
No, I'll stay cuffed in the springtime too. Yeah,
okay.
I want a long-term cuff, yeah.
Now, does your ideal person have to be suave like
they
you
have put- to be first of all a man because you know I'm gay,
okay,
but you know I like regular people, so you know,
okay,
I don't care about
Gucci and all that
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I don't care about that.
Okay A job, obviously.
Yes,
some employment,
right?
A nice person,
right? Yeah.
Handsome,
absolutely.
Okay Got you. Now, You're not getting married. That was a rumor.
And I'm very attracted to dark skin.
Dark skin?
Yes.
That's your thing?
That is my thing.
Okay. Dark as in Wesley Snipes dark?
Yeah.
Or as in Eddie Murphy dark?
Both. I think
both.
Yes. Dark.
Okay.
Chocolate.
Okay, chocolate. It's got to be chocolate.
Yes.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be, but that's my preference.
That's your preference?
Yeah.
So an I'll be sure type?
I'm not going to go for that. I mean, that wouldn't be my first choice. That would be like, you know,
okay,
way at the end of the line.
Okay, all right, way at the end of the line. Okay, yeah. So they said, somebody said, we knew y'all was gonna act surprised. I don't think a lot of people knew.
Because you should have known. They I told people this on your show the last time I was.
Yeah, that was how long ago was that?
Last year, wasn't it?
Last year. Yeah, it was about a year ago.
I mean, I don't. You know what I do is my business, so I'm not.
Right, you don't have nothing to prove.
It's, right, exactly. So
right.
People might be surprised by it, but it's nothing that I hide, you know.
Right.
I'm very open about who I am.
Right. Well, I was getting somebody, people were hitting me up saying, okay, his big announcement is he's getting married. That's a no-go.
That's not happening.
The other announcement was you were running for mayor.
That is not happening.
That's not happening.
No.
The other announcement was you were, what was the other one? You were running for mayor, you were getting married, and the other one was you were about to run some company.
Okay.
You were getting ready to run some company downtown, and shit was coming in like crazy. Now, you let me know when you're ready to tell these people, because I want to know, too.
We can go ahead and do it now. I mean, I think people have waited long enough. I'm ready to get it
ladies
out
ladies and gentlemen.
And people are welcome to call if they have questions.
Yeah, the number is at the bottom of the screen, 860-436-1363. You're more than welcome to call in, talk to Mario, and ask him a question. Say hello to him. You're not ready for no smoke tonight, right?
Because
they say Mario brings the tea, whatever that means. You know, you know the blacks. You know, he has the tea.
It's funny. That's a gay lingo, the tea.
He has the tea as a gay lingo?
That is gay lingo, yeah.
Oh, a lot.
I always laugh when the straights use gay lingo, but some of them are homophobic.
Okay. Oh, I know what the other rumor was, and I'm putting him on blast because when he said it earlier, I said I was going to put him on blast. Cameron Green texted me and said, I know what his announcement is. I said, what? He said, you and him are getting married.
Wait, me and who?
Me and you. And I said I was
you?
Putting me.
Okay.
First of all, I'm not dark skinned. I'm morbidly obese. I'm married. Can we grab this call before you get to know?
Go ahead.
We're gonna grab this call. It's the Raw Report. Mario Boone's in the house. What up?
Hey.
Turn your device down.
Okay. So whatever he is, he gets the job done right.
Thank you.
You got to turn your device down because you're behind.
Okay, wait a minute.
All right.
You got me?
We got you now.
Okay, so whatever he is, be proud of it. He gets his job done right.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
He definitely gets the job done.
Yes. Thank you.
All right, you're welcome. So, before we got the call, you said you was going to let everyone know.
Yeah, I'm ready to drop it. I'm ready to let people know what's up.
Mario Boone, the floor is yours, my brother.
Well, I'll just jump right into it. You know, I have, after much deliberation and where's the camera? I want to look right at the camera.
That's your camera right there.
Yeah, after much deliberation and thought, prayer, and just a lot, I've made the decision that I'm leaving Channel 8 News, WTNH.
Whoa.
I'm leaving.
You're leaving?
I'm leaving. That is the announcement. As a matter of fact, my 2-year anniversary is in October, and I've made the decision that I'm not gonna renew.
You're not gonna renew?
I am not.
Now, were you asked to renew?
I don't want to get into the inner workings of the contract negotiations and how things went, but I have decided that I'm moving on.
You want to move on?
I do. I feel like it's the right time. I feel like I've done most of what I wanted to do here.
Okay.
And I feel real good about the legacy that I'm going to leave behind and the work that I've been able to accomplish with the support of the community and the team that I work with.
A lot of sad faces jumping up on the screen.
Yeah, I'm sorry. But, you know,
Let me ask you, does it have anything to do with New Haven in a whole?
No, because this is another part of the announcement. I haven't decided if I'm actually going to leave New Haven. I just might still be here. I don't know yet.
But you're leaving?
I'm leaving Channel 8.
You're leaving Channel 8.
I don't know if I'm leaving New Haven just yet.
Okay. Yeah. So we might still see you.
You might. I still have quite a few other opportunities that I'm looking at.
Have they came your way?
I've gotten several opportunities that have been presented to me, and I'm looking at some options at this time. So we'll see what happens. This is truly a step out on faith kind of thing. Like nothing is set in stone.
So you prayed on this, you thought about it.
I have. Nothing is set in stone. I haven't made up my mind as far as what my next step will be.
Okay.
But I feel like this step is the right step for me, and I'm taking it. So
I got you, man. Now, is it? Well, you can't get into the particulars, but did you?
That felt so good to release because I've been holding that in for so long. And,
really?
Only a couple people have been told about this. So it feels really good to be able to finally publicly say that. And let me just say this, too. You know, I always told you that whatever I decided to do, I was going to come here and do it.
Yes, you did.
And
we discussed this months ago.
Right. Yeah. And I just want everybody in Facebook land to know this is not by accident or happenstance that I'm here on the Raw Report making this announcement. Because, Rob, first of all, let me thank you because when I came here the first time, I was very unsure about coming to this platform. And actually, you know, people reached out to me and told me not to come.
Yes, they,
you did. And I came here anyway, and I feel like that was one of the best decisions I made.
I appreciate you, brother.
Coming to New Haven.
I really do.
And so I feel like coming to your show really gave me the hood stamp of approval that I needed.
Yes.
And so it was a no-brainer that this decision would be announced on your show.
I appreciate you. I really
first,
do.
First, I haven't said this publicly anywhere. This is the first time I'm making this announcement. So
does Channel 8 know?
Yes.
Okay.
But
okay.
I'm talking publicly.
Publicly, right.
Yeah, I mean, you always got to talk to your employer first and let them know. But
outside
of that, you're the first person
to. Appreciate that, brother. I really do. Yeah.
So I want people at home and people who are watching this to understand the power of your platform.
Okay.
And, you know, you're everywhere, too. I see you all over the place with the camera and stuff.
Right.
So people need to realize, like, your show is that show.
I appreciate that, man.
So that's why I came here to do this.
I really appreciate you coming on. And I remember the first time I reached out to you to come on, and it got blown all that. He's not coming.
Right.
He's not coming. Can I grab this call?
Go ahead, yeah.
We're going to grab this call. It's the Raw Report. Talk to us.
Hey.
Hi.
I wanted to ask him, will he still be on Facebook News?
reporting on Facebook?
I will still have a Facebook presence and Twitter and all of that stuff. So people will still be able to communicate with me via my social media accounts.
So where would you get your news from?
Well, I have a network of sources all over the state. So, you know, it doesn't matter where I, what network I work for. People trust me, so they come to me with information.
No, I'm saying, like, you still going to be, like, on the streets of New Haven, like, right there finding out the news, reporting it?
If I remain here, probably, yes.
Could you do that without working for Action News 8?
Anybody can do that. You don't have to work.
Okay.
Yeah, you could, you know, I'm Mario regardless of where I work. Mm-hmm. You know, my name,
right.
My name precedes me, so I don't. Yeah, and I don't say that in a boastful, braggadocious way either.
Right. Another question. Do you ever feel unsafe for the news that you report with all the threats and the backlash that you get on social media?
I have only felt unsafe once in my entire career, and that was, you know, that was a face-to-face encounter I had with a group of people who didn't like a report that I was doing. I've never felt unsafe except for that one time. I don't feel unsafe. People, you know, this is my job, you know, it kind of is what it is. That's my best answer.
Right. Okay.
Is this First Lady in North Carolina? You got them, they're coming from North Carolina and everything. For you.
Yes, it is.
I knew it was you.
Of course you did. You know I was calling in. Love you, Rob.
I love you too.
Well, take care, Mario.
Thank you.
Best luck on your ventures.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Bye. Let me grab it.
I really appreciate the people that are reaching out and showing me love. I got a list of people I want to thank too when we get an opportunity.
Okay, go ahead, callers. It's the Raw Report. Mario Boone's in the building.
This is Kiana Jarman.
All right, what's up, Kim? Turn your device down,
like
Kim.
To ask a question, I would like to know, can you and Mario maybe do something in the future together since he's not on Channel 8?
I would do something tomorrow. This guy is, he's a big deal. So, you know.
And let me just say, I'll still be on the news through October, sometime mid-October. So I haven't left yet. I'll still be around for the next couple of weeks.
Okay. Go ahead, callers. It's the Raw Report. Mario Boone's in the building. She got her.
Okay.
Kim, did you hear that?
Yes.
All right. All right. Thanks, Kim. Now, let me. I know you want to say something to somebody, but a young lady who's watching this right now, she's a big deal. Her name is Georgia Davis, and she was the one who put this idea in my head. Start doing, because there's something, you know, try it out.
Right.
And you have all my support. Georgia Davis, I love you. You know, I always love you. We see each other all the time. And she's always, well, Mario Boone, because she's a picture-taking fanatic. She doesn't charge anybody, but she should. But
yeah.
Now, did it hurt your feelings when you had to make this decision?
I wouldn't say it hurt my feelings, but it was a tough decision to make. Because I really do feel, after 2 years, I feel really invested in this community and in this state, in this region.
Right.
And I feel like the news and the job that I do, I feel like it really resonates with people. And I say that because of the outpouring of support that I receive and the fact that people really trust me. You know, people call me with the most unbelievable stories.
Right.
Of hardship and just unbelievable stuff that they're going through at the worst moment in their life.
Right.
And they trust me
with
to
that.
Be able to tell right. that story. So that means a lot to me. So to it's almost like a breakup, to have to break up with those people who've put their trust in me and respect me. That's difficult. It's not easy.
Right.
So this was not an easy announcement to make, but I knew it was the right thing for me.
It was the right thing. So it's not that you will be leaving Connecticut.
I don't know yet.
You don't know yet.
I have not made that decision. So the only thing I've decided at this point is I'm leaving WTNH.
Yes.
I have not made a final decision on next steps after that. And that's why I said this is a faith walk. Because I'm really letting God lead me to the next point where I'm supposed to be. Listen, I had no idea I was ever coming to Connecticut in the first place. This was not my plan to be here. I never set out to say, I'm moving to Connecticut. Just that wasn't my plan in life. But this is where God brought me, and I ended up here. So
right.
I'm just going to let that unfold in the next realm of
now my, did you, my next opportunity. I see that. Now, did you had a chance to work with everybody, right? Like Keith Koontz.
Oh, yeah.
All those guys. They, right. Were they a great team, great people to work
Absolutely.
With?
Absolutely. You know, great team and really hardworking people.
Really hardworking, yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. I understand. This is a big deal, man. This is a big deal. But you said this is what you know what's best for you.
I do. I mean, listen, right now, even as I sit here, it's I don't know. I don't want to say uncomfortable, but it's, I'm a little nervous because I don't want people to feel like I'm abandoning them and walking out on them because, you know, people really do. And again, I don't say this in a braggadocious kind of way, but people, for whatever reason, have connected with me in such a way. They tell me all the time, I only watch the news because you're on there. So I don't know. I just don't want people to feel like I'm walking out on them.
Right. Now, I was down at, when they had the protest for the shooting.
Right.
I was over, remember when it was at Hampden Plaza?
Right.
Right around. And it was some reporters out there, and it was like, I heard one of them say, follow Mario because he knows where it's at. And the lady was like, I know, follow him, follow Mario. And I was like, oh, they vibing off of you. I'm sure the office, I'm sure the phones will, phones are ringing. Because I was like, oh shit. And over at the, down by the Yale.
Yeah.
They were like, I could see them following you around to see what you would do next.
Well, that's what happens when you have built a solid network of sources and people who trust you and they give you info.
Right.
They know I have the information. So I would follow me too if I was there, you know.
Oh, that was cocky.
I don't want to take no shots at nobody, but you know, that's kinda, that's how the news.
Shot away if you want to. Shot away.
That's how it works. You follow who has the info.
Who has the info, right. And it seemed like when they followed you around and then when you left, they left.
A large part of my day is spent ducking other reporters because I don't want them to know what I have.
Really?
Yes.
Do they ever ask you?
No. Nobody, I hope, would be that.
From other than Channel 8.
I will say, though, no, there was a time where I don't want to throw under the bus, but a reporter did come up to me once and ask me about some info on a story we were out on. And so I don't want to throw under the bus, but I would never. I would personally never.
You would
do
never
that.
Do that.
No.
So you're at the top of your game.
I want people to understand I am a very humble individual.
Absolutely.
I'm not arrogant. My head is not in the clouds. I'm about as normal as you will find for a person who's on TV every day.
Right.
So I'm reluctant to say, you know, I'm at the top of my game because first of all, we can all always improve.
Right.
So I don't use those kinds of descriptions of myself because I just think I'm pretty average, you know, pretty normal.
You're getting a lot of love this time. Mario, you can't leave. Many blessings to you. We appreciate you. Somebody said the police got you. Okay.
No, that's not true.
That's a new rumor. He got a case. He got a police case. All that reporting and now you got a case. But I believe a lot of people, more people love you than don't love you.
I hope so. I would like to think so.
I mean, I'm sure that you, I see that you catch a lot. You catch flat.
Yeah.
Could you, somebody just put up there, run for mayor. Could you run for mayor of the city of New Haven and win?
I think any resident who is a resident in good standing, I don't know what the qualifications are. I think you have to be a resident. I am a resident of New Haven, but I'm not running for mayor. I don't want to. I have no desire to be in politics.
I appreciate you bringing this big news up here because...
Can I thank a couple people real quick?
You can, absolutely.
And then we can take calls if you want. But okay. So I must thank Keith Connors. Keith Connors was my initial boss at Channel 8. He was the news director who hired me and brought me here in July of 2017. And of course, I want to thank my agent, Rick Evers.
You have an agent?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So I want to thank my agent, Rick Evers, who put me together with Keith, and Keith saw my work and he liked it and he hired me. He brought me in. I always like to, you know, never forget people who look out for me. And Keith looked out for me. So Keith now is the news director at Channel 3.
Okay.
So Keith, you know, if you're out there and you hear this, thank you for taking the chance on me and, right, and offering right. me a job and bringing me here to Connecticut. And I won't forget that.
Yeah, I don't know if you know who Chun Li is. She said, if you leave, who am I going to intern with? Now, a young lady just put Juanita said, I hate power. This is not political. This had nothing
that
to do
I'm
with.
Leaving?
Yeah, like you being pushed out or forced out.
Yeah, I'm not going to comment on
it. Right, okay,
like
okay,
that.
Okay. Yeah, we can't get into particulars. Yeah, man, I mean, it's probably. Can we take this call?
Go ahead.
It's the Roar Report. What's up?
Hello.
Hello.
Is this the Roar Report?
Yes, it is. Hi.
Hello.
Oh, wait.
Turn your device down because you're going to get confused.
All right. You can hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Hi, Bessie. I am so sad that you're leaving the news station, but I know you're going to get a good job and do well.
Wait, did somebody give you a... Dusty?
Bestie.
Oh, Bestie. Oh, okay.
Bestie. He knows exactly who this is. That's my Bestie in my head.
She said in her head. Let me hit her.
No, thank you so much. Nicole, thank you. I appreciate that a lot.
No problem. I know wherever you go, you're going to be nosy, and we're still going to be nosy together. Don't you worry.
I'm not nosy. I'm curious.
Well, we're going to be curious together. Don't you worry. I got your back.
Okay.
All right. Have a good night.
Bye. All right, Bestie.
You know, Rob, I do want to take an opportunity and thank all of my sources out there.
Right.
I wish I could name them. I can't name them because
their sources.
You know, sources are confidential.
Right.
But I will say, and I brought my calendar because I was going to go down the list of all of the exclusive stories I've broke and all of the stories
that
I was first to report. But I have to say, you know, I have a long list of accomplishments on this thing here, but probably 99% of these stories I would not have been able to do if not for my sources.
Really?
So I want to take this opportunity and thank all of my sources across the state of Connecticut, because I would not have been anywhere near as successful as I am without sources who trust me. And people need to understand, there is a significant amount of trust that a source places in somebody when they share information, because
right.
you're trusting that this person will maintain your confidentiality
right.
because your job could be on the line, or your freedom in some cases could be on the line, or
right.
your life maybe.
Right.
So people have trusted me, and I have maintained that code, that bond with each source that I've developed over the last 2 years. And I have to say thank you to each of them if they're listening, because you know, I couldn't have done this without them. So, you know, last week I did a story about a New Haven police officer who had a gang background. He was suspected of being
I watched that.
Of being in a Bloods gang. And that story, by the way, took off and it went viral. And other stations and other media outlets ended up picking that story up and running it. And I wouldn't have been able to do that story without a source, a very highly placed source. So that's what I mean by sources are so important to what journalists do. The president wouldn't be in trouble right now if it wasn't for a source.
A source, right, no. right.
So thank you to all my sources.
The source, now, a source like that, something like that, do you ever be afraid of being harassed by police because of things like that?
Yeah, and I have been.
You've been harassed by police?
Yes, because of certain stories that I've done. I was the subject of a campaign by some first responders who wanted to get me fired because I was reporting a lot of misconduct within the fire department here in New Haven.
Okay.
With firemen who were testing positive for drugs. And I came under significant backlash, and there was a campaign mounted to try and get me fired. Yeah, there is a price to pay when you're breaking these kinds of stories, but that is the job that I signed up to do, and I'm happy to do it.
Okay. So it is a big job. Can't everybody do? So you wouldn't deem yourself an investigative reporter, right?
Well, remember we talked about this. That's not
right.
my official title, but those
right.
are the kinds of stories I do.
I
investigate stuff. I would not say that's what I am because that's not my official title, but that
right.
is what I do.
Okay. I'm sure you'll land nicely. I know that.
I'm dependent on God.
So right.
Whatever happens, I know.
Could you handle a New York or
of course.
A big, you know, a huge stage like
that? I went to a HBCU. I can handle anything.
That's right. It's
an HBCU. Shout out to Clark Atlanta University.
Here we go. Shout out Clark. And I know it go down there.
Yeah, and the motto is at Clark Atlanta, and this is in my email tagline. I will find a way or make one. So, I can handle anywhere just based off of that experience.
Let me grab this call. It's the Roar Report. We got Mario Boone in the building. What's up? Talk to us.
Hi. I just wanted to ask Mario, what was his favorite story he ever did the whole time he's been with Channel 8? Wow.
You know, I don't know if I have a favorite, but I do have one of the most memorable stories. You guys remember the CT Transit bus driver who was attacked?
Yes.
With the metal cane.
Yes.
Remember that? And he was defending Stefan Knox. Shout out to Stefan.
Yeah.
He was defending himself at work when he came under assault.
Right.
And he got fired for defending himself. And of course, we found out about it and we got the video. We broke that story. It was a story I broke thanks to a source.
Thanks.
And because of the work that we did, we were able to help Stefan get his job back. So for me, that is one of the most impactful and most memorable stories that I've done throughout the entire time I've been here. And there are some others, but that one particularly sticks out because here's a man who is at work trying to provide for his family. You know, has children, I think he had a kid in college, a kid in high school, a wife. He's doing what we're supposed to do, go to work and provide for his family.
Right.
And then he gets attacked at work by a crazed madman and he's trying to defend himself and then they fire him. It was outrageous. I was so happy to put that on blast so he could get his job back. So that's the story I won't ever forget.
I
still run into him from time to time. He passes me on the bus and he'll wave or blow the horn. And I'm just like, wow, I'm glad I was able to play a small part in him getting his job back.
And that man got his job back. Yeah. And he whipped a little ass in the process.
Well, Mario, I just want to tell you thank you for being there for New Haven. We all loved you. We loved your stories.
Thank you.
Good luck on your new chapter in life.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
All right. Good night. Thanks, Rob. Good night.
All right. Now, sources, is that a cute word for snitch? Because I'm all for snitching. I'll tell somebody in a second. I'm not going to fight you. I'm going to call law enforcement.
Yes, and I will too. I don't like that word, though. I don't like the word snitch because it has a negative connotation.
Right.
I guess you could use that word.
Right.
I don't personally like to use the word snitch.
Right. Go ahead. It's the Roar Report. What's up?
Hey.
Hi.
Hi. I'm one of Mario's top fans on Facebook.
Oh, are you? You got that little thing next to your name every time you comment?
Yes.
You think you're a big deal?
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
And I think he does a tremendous job.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that a lot.
And I think Channel 8 has become better since you've been on the air.
I would agree with that.
And it's a tremendous loss to the city and the state. And I hope you, wherever you go, you end up, you do the same for that community as you did here for New Haven. And I wish you good luck. Don't want you to go, but, you know, This is a testament of the great job you're doing. And I'm sure Channel 8 has something to do with you leaving, because I'm sure the other reporters weren't getting their shine and you were getting all the good stuff. So,
well, thank you. Thank you for your kind words, and I appreciate the support.
Yes. Good luck to you. And don't go to New York and be on Fox 5 with Ryan Christopher, because we don't get that channel.
No,
down
go
here
to New York with Ryan Christopher and get those big bucks. Don't listen to her.
Get the money. By all means, get the money. But it's a tremendous loss. I for half the information that you gave us here in New Haven on the news by reporting, majority of us would have never have gotten that information, because the people who do not look like us don't care about us and don't want to really report on anything other than one of us dying in the street.
Well, thank you for your support. And, I'll tell you, Rob, another story that's very memorable to me.
Thank you, dear.
Oh, you're welcome.
All right. Thank you so much.
Okay. Bye-bye. You have a good evening, everyone.
You too.
But another story that I'll leave here and it'll definitely go with me is the story of You remember Tyquan Nesbitt, that story. She was killed in front of her two children on Wilmot.
Right.
You know, it's a story that that still bothers me even to this day. And then, of course, the Paul Witherspoon, Stephanie Washington story, the police shooting from Yale and Hamden.
Right.
That's a story that bothers me. It's still to this day, it bothers me. It's the first story, and then what ended up happening with Paul getting arrested with the hit and run.
Right.
You know, that's a perfect example of how, on one hand, I was beloved when I got that video and it showed that he wasn't in, you know, didn't have a gun and didn't rob somebody. You know, the gas station video. And then we got the video of, actually it was my colleague who got the video first showing the actual police shooting.
Right.
Kent Pierce got the video first. And then we got additional video that showed more of the shooting. I was beloved. People had lifted me up on a mantle. But then the hit and run happened. And I got the video of the hit and run showing Paul hit the guy on the bike and then drive off. And I literally went from hero to villain. Right. I got so much hate mail, and people hated my guts. And
did they actually say they hated you? They hated you.
Well, they didn't use that word hate, but they were hating.
They weren't happy with.
They were not happy with me showing that video. But you know, again, and this is just another example of you're doing your job if you're hated on both sides, because I would have been, it would have been unethical and improper for me to ignore that video of Paul allegedly hitting that guy on the bike. And I just couldn't ignore it. It's not something I would do. It wouldn't make me any better than any of these other people, you know, who tell half of a story. So, you know, I didn't like having to show that video. I didn't want for it to be true, but it was true and I had to show it.
Now, was that decision yours to show it, or that decision of...
Well, for it to run on the news, on TV, that was the station's decision. But I posted it on my social media accounts, which was my decision.
Right. Okay. Because most people go to your account before they go to the news.
Well, that's what we try to do. Digital first is our motto.
Your digital game is...
That's the new way of how people get news content now.
Yeah, they get it from there first.
Right.
That's where I usually see it.
Right.
Before I even see it on the news.
Yeah.
Like sometimes you'll see it there and you won't see it on the news until 11 o'clock at night.
That's true.
And it's like, dude, you think that's killing... TV?
TV is definitely on decline. That is true.
Right.
TV is on decline. I think in 5 years, the whole landscape of TV will be totally different. It's not going to look like it looks right now.
Right. Yeah, I believe that because...
More and more people will be watching content on their device and not on TV.
Tablet, phone, mostly phone.
Right.
Yeah, man, in case you just joined us, you don't know. Oh, that's right. Judy Slaughter said, don't forget about ShopRite Susie. You remember that?
How could I forget ShopRite Susie? I do remember ShopRite Susie.
ShopRite Susie, you know, that's right. How could you forget that?
That case, that one is that's a memorable story. I won't ever forget that one.
Right.
Because, you know, ShopRite Susie, I don't know if people know, you remember when there was a police chase that came from Hamden and it crossed over into New Haven?
Yes.
Brandon Sheely was driving the car and his friend Jarrell Gibbs was killed.
Right.
The crash where that car crashed was right in front of ShopRite Susie's house. And ShopRite Susie...
Really?
Yes. People don't know this, but ShopRite Susie was the very first person to call 911 to report that there was a man dying in front of her house. And Hamden police came out and tried to say they weren't actively chasing the car when the crash happened. And ShopRite Susie was one of the witnesses who... said, yes, the cops were chasing these people.
So ShopRite Susie.
So I don't know what went wrong. Something went terribly wrong.
She was, ShopRite Susie was rocking with the black folks, and then something went wrong.
Something happened with ShopRite Susie. But that's a story I won't ever forget.
I forgot all about ShopRite Susie.
I won't forget ShopRite Susie. Every time I drive past a ShopRite, I think about ShopRite Susie.
Really? And that happened in front of her house.
It happened. The crash did.
The crash did.
Right? The tree they hit is directly in front of their house, in her house. Well, she doesn't live there anymore, but it was directly.
I'm going to grab this. June Kiss said, are you able to teach journalism? Would you be considering? Would you consider that?
I would consider that. Yeah, I would definitely. I think we need more black people in journalism. You know, we need more black journalists.
We need more black journalists.
We do need more black journalists, yeah.
No doubt. Absolutely. I saw some people up there saying, snitch, no, I'm a police caller. I am a police caller. Yes, I am. Mario, you, oh man. Now how, what, I don't know.
You know, I'll tell you one of the other sad stories I covered that, you know, really impacted me was the shooting of Captain Duff.
Okay.
Because we knew, you know, I think I was one of the first people, I was the first reporter at the hospital emergency room reporting outside. So I knew really, really early that it was Captain Duff who had been shot.
Now, do you know him?
I do. Captain Duff was the public information officer for the police department. Okay. So he interacts with the press as part of his job. So okay. I do him well because he is somebody we go to for information when we need to get official police info. So I had worked with Captain Duff on a number of stories.
Okay.
And it's funny, when we got word about that shooting, I emailed Captain Duff to ask, hey, what's going on? You know, I heard it was a police shooting. Not knowing at the time that he was the one who had been shot.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So I found out pretty quickly it was him. And it was very tough to try to keep it together because we didn't know at the time if he was going to survive. Oh, okay. So I was reporting on somebody who I knew personally in a professional sense, who I respect a lot.
Okay.
And I think he's a great guy. And that was a tough one for
now. Did you catch any flack? Because when I watched it, it was like people were saying, would they be out in force like this if it wasn't a cop
Yeah,
shot?
And people for some reason thought we didn't want to talk to the family of the man, Troy Clark, who was killed.
Right.
And that wasn't true. We just didn't know who he was at the time. Because remember, it took them several days to officially identify him.
Right.
So once we found out who he was, we went and found his sister and we interviewed her.
Right. I
did. So, you know, people, this is people who are not journalists trying to tell me how to do my job, and I have to run folks again, stay in your lane,
right?
Because we were actively working trying to find out who the deceased victim was.
Okay.
It's just we had to wait for the cops. We can't, you know, we can't just go to the medical examiner and walk in and say, let me see which bodies you got in here. We have to wait for the police to tell, unless the family contacts me and says that was my brother, we don't know. We have to wait for the police.
Okay.
And that's what happened in that case. So there was a lot of flack in that situation. Because people, for whatever reason, thought the press in general did not want to talk to the victim who died. And they said we were making the story about this police officer, and that just wasn't true.
Okay, I have a question. It's a controversial question. If you don't want me to ask it, I won't ask it. But it's a question that's on, it's on the board right now. If I can't ask it, I don't have it. I don't know if you can see it.
No, I don't.
Holly Tucker said, are you leaving simply because WTNH had you enslaved to the job and mostly only allowed you to cover stories on black people committing crimes?
Well, first of all, that is not true.
And that's what we talked about earlier.
That is not true. And that's obviously a person who doesn't watch the news every day.
Okay.
That's not true. As a matter of fact, I just did a story, and this is why I keep this calendar. So when people like that send in questions that make no sense, I can just debunk that myth right away. But I just did a story yesterday about Justice Davis Graham. You know who that is? Justice Davis Graham. He's a 12-year-old boy from New Haven. He's a child actor.
From the Wu-Tang.
He's from the Wu-Tang series.
Okay, yeah.
Now, Justice ain't committed no crime. He ain't been in trouble. He is doing what most kids are doing, going to school, learning, becoming a stand-up young man.
Right.
So if what she said is true, we wouldn't have done that story. So we don't even have to address that anymore.
Okay, definitely. So, and he's on his way.
He's on his way. People should follow him. Justice Davis Graham. He's going to be the next Denzel Washington.
Yes.
I'm calling it now.
You calling it out now?
Yes, he's going to be the next big name.
Okay, and I know, I thought you was about to get churchy on me and say you, how do they say it at church? I'm claiming it.
Yes, name it and claim it.
I'm naming it and claiming it. Man, I hope you don't leave, man. I really do. I really hope you stick around.
I appreciate that.
But if something
else comes up, I'll come back and let you know. You'll be the first person to know, Rob.
I feel like a big deal now.
I feel like I'm leaving some things out, but you know, I'll remember.
No, whatever you don't leave anything out. Because I know a lot of people do watch the show because of you. When they first saw you come along, they saw the hat. I don't think New Haven has ever had anything a person like you before.
No, I would agree with that.
The hat.
I will say that I'll name it and claim it right now. There will never be another Mario Boone. Never.
Ah, he got cocky. And I offered him beer. And he, ladies and gentlemen, I offered him beer.
I don't
and he
drink.
Said no.
I don't drink.
Okay. Yeah. So I don't think.
I'm surprised we didn't have more questions, but I appreciate the people.
They have some. Let me see. Did they answer my question about what's more racist, Connecticut or North Carolina?
You know what? I don't know, man. I'm telling you, I've seen some stuff since I've lived here that
racist.
I didn't even deal with down south.
Really?
My grandmother always says it's up south.
It's this part is up south.
Up south, right?
Oh,
yes. Because a lot of stuff that you deal with up here is no different than what you deal with down south, which surprised me when I got here. I wasn't prepared for that.
A young lady, Sabrina, said, "Tell him I appreciate him for getting back to me on that school bus situation with my sons. Thank you."
Absolutely. You know, that was a big debacle, that whole school bus thing.
The whole school bus thing.
Big debacle. Never seen anything like that before. Hopefully they've got it resolved, because there were a lot of parents who were very upset, and they were blowing up my email box. We did a couple stories about it. And then they got mad at me because I went to the school board meeting and it was empty. And I posted the picture showing an empty auditorium with no parents present.
And you caught flack for that, right?
I did, because they said, "Oh, you're shaming parents who have to work." And,
right.
But, you know, y'all blowing my inbox up complaining about no buses. Go to the meeting.
Right. Yeah, it wasn't maybe 20. You say about 15, 20?
Go to the meeting.
Shout out to Ife, who invited me. You know Ife?
Yeah.
She invited me there. She works really hard, man.
She does.
She does. Her and Robin Godwin, they both work extremely hard on this thing, man. That's going to be funny, because I don't know if they might take a hit from this.
I hope not. There's still a lot of good people over there.
So. Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. I mean, I usually watch it in the morning. Now, do they purposely put pretty faces on to draw people?
Look, I don't make those kind of decisions about staffing, so I don't know what the reasons are. They do research, and research tells them who works better in what slot. And I think they follow that.
So a heavy set chick wouldn't work out?
I don't know, because let me tell you, I spend all of my time focusing on
you,
me, and how I can be better.
Right.
So I'm not concerned about who's to my left or right, what they look like, what they wear, what size they are. I'm concerned about Mario.
Now, does somebody give you pointers on what to do and how to?
Yeah.
Because I do see you sometimes, you'll be on and you're like, "I'm Mario Boone," and you'll do this. Well,
if you notice, so I don't wear my big glasses anymore on the news.
What did you get? Did they make you? Did someone
say
something?
Nobody made me, but I had a consultant to tell me that it didn't present me in the best light, and so they wanted me to look more presentable.
Really?
Yeah. So I took that advice, and so I stopped wearing these on the news.
Okay.
So when I first got here, these were really to catch people's attention so I could really be.
Oh, you did?
So I could be introduced to the community, and I wanted people to remember me.
Right.
Hello?
And that's what this
helped
me to do.
Hold on. Go ahead, caller.
So I have a question for Mario.
Okay.
So my question is, what advice would you give WT diverse when it comes to minority and the stories that cover?
Can you just start your question over, because I missed the first part of it?
Yeah, your phone is really, really crunchy.
I don't know. My wife is probably So what advice would you give W teenagers to be more diverse when it comes to covering news of the minorities?
Well, first, let's just start covering the minority communities. I don't think we do enough of it. And that's not just us. That's all news outlets. We need to do a better job of not only covering the minority community, but including minority representation on the air and behind the scenes. And I definitely do not think there's enough of that. And, you know, you can just turn the TV on and see that for yourself. So I think we have to do a better job of being more inclusive. And yeah, that's my answer to that.
So why do you think the news station excludes us from major stories?
Because people don't demand coverage. It's just that simple. It's a public airway, first of all. And if you guys demanded certain things be covered, then we would cover it. It's just like voting. Okay. It's just like voting. If you don't vote, then your, you know, your complaint really doesn't matter. Politicians pay attention to people who vote. Same thing with us.
So do you think that it took a man of color for people of color to watch the news?
Probably, because people identify with who they are, you know, look like. So, yeah, that's not a secret. I mean, people are more closely align themselves with who they have a connection with, whether it be race or maybe you went to the same school or even family. So, yeah.
Okay, and I have one last question. So you came up here from down south. So did you think it was harder for you to get into the business in your own community versus outside of your community? Like, did you not have the support? And since you're on TV, when you see backlash from, you know, people of your background, does it make you feel some type of way that, you know, everybody isn't standing behind you since you are the face of the community?
No, because, you know, one thing I've learned at my age is that you're never going to please everybody. So I don't take it personal when people take shots at me, you know, because everybody has an opinion and they're going to all, you know, everybody's not going to love you. So, I don't dwell on that kind of stuff.
You have tough skin.
You have to in this business. You have to.
Okay, that's what I wanted to call and say. Hi, Rob.
Hey, how you doing? You have tough skin, too.
I know I do.
All right.
Can I give a quick shout out to Brenda Bosky Hill? I hope I said her last
Brenda,
name right.
I seen that. Oh, okay. Yeah definitely. Do your thing.
Because Brenda, first of all, she gave me a shout out in an article that she was in. I think it was in the Independent.
I saw that. Yeah.
And she shouted me out. And then she invited me over to her house to look at her eyewear. And by the way, she makes these fantastic glasses. I don't know if you've seen her eyewear, but she makes these frames that are bedazzled with crystals and stuff. And she gave me a pair. So shout out to Brenda. Thank you. Do you have them?
You didn't bring them?
I still have them. I didn't bring them with me. They're at home. But I do still have the eyewear that she gave me. So,
oh, that's what's up, Brenda. Yeah, I see
Brenda
her
Fosky Hill. I'm pretty Brenda sure that's Fosky how Hill. You say
I,
it.
I see yeah, her a lot.
So shout out to Brenda. And then I also saw a message on here from Chantel, who she gave me permission to say she gave me the tip on the Abate's pizza situation. You remember the Abate's kid who hit the two people over at Yale or by Yale?
Uh-huh.
And then he drove to Abate's Pizza and was found hiding in the freezer.
Right.
Well, she called me and gave me that tip. And she also followed the guy, which helped to get him arrested.
Okay.
So she's getting a citation from the city for stepping up and being
stepping up and doing the right thing.
So shouts out to Chantel.
Yeah, you're getting a lot of love. You're getting a lot of love, and I'm hoping wherever you go, I'll still watch. I'll definitely watch.
Thank you.
Brenda
Fosky Hill she used to be an older person in New Haven.
Brenda Fosky Hill. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
BDH Designs is her.
Oh, wow.
By the way, I hope you're going to still get Marcus on.
I spoke to him.
Okay. Is that going to work out?
Yeah, you definitely.
Yeah. Shout out to Marcus from New Era Remodeling.
Yep. I did speak to him.
So let me tell you real quick before I have to go. I did a story about the New Haven 911 Dispatch Center.
Was that getting at them? Or
it was just telling the truth. I don't know if
it did look nice in there.
It did. I don't know if they considered it getting at them.
It looked nice in there.
So I got a tip from somebody inside the 911 center that they had spent all this money remodeling the kitchen. And so they were concerned that taxpayer dollars were being wasted. So I asked for the record showing how much it cost. And it was actually cheaper than what I was originally told.
Right.
So I just posted the records and the pictures of the repair job. And Marcus, my new homeboy, that's my homie now, Marcus hit me up and was like, yo, I did that work.
Right.
So shouts out to me.
Shouts out. And he hit me.
I hit him up. I was like, thank you. You know, he hit me back. It was like, I got a hat for you. So he came up to the station. I invited him over to the station. He came over and brought me a New Era hat. We took pictures in the studio. And so that's like my homeboy. Like, his story is so amazing.
Yeah.
So I got to give him a shout out if anybody needs to get their house remodeled, hit Marcus up.
Yeah.
But his story is so amazing, like how he turned his life around, you know, from being younger and getting into trouble and stuff. And now he's owning his own business and he's running his own company.
Absolutely.
So I got to give a big shout out to him. You know, we went and had brunch one day, last weekend, I think, or weekend before last. We went and had brunch and we just had a long conversation you know, just talking about like where we came from and how our how our lives intersected, you know, which was like so odd because we would have never met each other had it not been for that story I did.
Right.
So people were coming at me, you know, on Facebook saying how horrible of a person I was because I was talking about the 911 dispatchers getting a new kitchen. And out of that
something came.
Yeah, like I formed a really cool friendship, I would like to say, or the beginning of a friendship with my new homeboy Marcus. And I really got a chance to learn about his story and like where he came from and, you know, help maybe put his business on Front Street so he can really take it to another level. So I'm glad at least that came out.
He did reach out. He did. We did talk. He did reach out to me.
So hopefully you'll get him on here.
So Mario Boone is so how much longer? At Channel 8?
I think the next couple of weeks, but definitely in October I'll be going. I'm still trying to finalize an exit date, but in the next couple of weeks I'll be wrapping things up.
I'm trying to, how will they fill those shoes?
And you know, it's funny because I have still so many stories that people are hitting me up with that I would love to be able to do, but I don't think I'm going to have time to do. So
right, because yeah.
So
can we grab this last call before we get out of here? It's the Raw Report. What's good? Talk to us. Mario's here.
I have a question. Ask Mario, what happened to the black lady that used to work there that got caught?
I don't know.
Out of Macy's.
People ask me that.
Why the hell did you bring that up?
I've never met her.
Yo, that joke was so funny. Like, when he heard, like, how's this doing? Is she okay?
I don't know.
Like, they don't talk about her no more.
I get asked that question, Rob, all the time. I have never met Desiree. Whatever she's doing, I hope she's doing well. I don't know her.
Desiree Fontaine, right?
Oh, that's her name. Okay, another thing. When you were on vacation, you had the cutest quote. You said, any questions or concerns, forward them to Jesus. That's Yo, right. That was so cute. So can you are say you, that?
Take it to the Lord.
Excuse me, are you making a pass at Mario Boone? What is wrong with you, lady?
No, but I just liked it, that phrase. That any phrase questions is, or concerns,
forward it to Jesus.
Forward it to Jesus.
Yes.
That junk was so funny. Like, that's all in my group chat.
And I meant that, seriously.
Yeah.
So, once again, congratulations on whatever you got going on, and I hope everything works out. We will miss you.
Thank you.
And that's it.
Thank you.
thank you for calling, all right?
Rob, all right, I appreciate you. It, man. I
appreciate you, man, bringing it here first, man. You know, the door is always open, man.
Yeah,
I'm
going to leave here and head straight to the flea market to see what I can find over there.
Wait, sir. The flea is not open today.
Oh, okay.
Saturday mornings, 8 o'clock. It costs $2 to get in.
Oh, they charge you to get in.
It's only $2.
Oh, wow.
It's $2. Hey, it's $2 to get in.
Let me just say, listen, for the next week or two, I'm doing pictures. I don't care where y'all see me. You can call me if I'm at the station. You can come by. We'll do a picture at the station. So wherever y'all see me, stop me, and I'm taking a picture with you. I don't care where it is, when, as long as I look decent. You know, if I'm in my basketball shorts and a t-shirt, I probably don't.
Wait, now where you shop at the flea market? They got some stuff there.
Well, they said I bought my Gucci there, so I may go see if I can find something there. You know?
Now they do have a cologne. The real cologne is called Blue Sky, but the flea market, it's called Sky Blue. it smells exactly the same, Mario. Come on, man.
Well, you know, listen, the people said I buy stuff from the flea market, so I'm going to go there and see if I can find some, you know, a few pieces.
You go there, you get socks, you get underwear, you can get Timberland.
Socks
at
the flea market. You know, it's funny. Somebody called me up and offered, or not called, they texted me and offered to sell me some polo underwear that apparently somebody had boosted from the Clinton outlets.
What the hell is wrong with you, black people? Damn it. Yo, that's hilarious. Yeah, you definitely.
Just for the record, I do not buy stolen property.
You can't. Because then somebody will put you on blast.
Of course they will, yeah.
You know, and it's like, you know, well, if you do have any stuff that you're boosting, please reach out to me. Oh, yo, Mario, man, I really appreciate you, man. I hope everything goes amazing for you. I know it will, because you're that guy, man.
Yeah,
you'll do well.
Thank you.
You'll do well, man. And again, man, thank you for everything you've done. It's not easy what you do.
It's not easy.
It's not easy at all.
No, it's not easy at all.
I don't know how they'll fill that slot. That's like Jordan leaving. Somebody did call you the GOAT up here.
Oh, okay.
Somebody said he's the GOAT.
I appreciate definitely that.
So I don't know. They said, don't do it, Mario. Stay out the flea. Stay out the police. I'm in there every, as much as I can get in there, I'm in there. But man,
wow.
Thank you, man. Really. Yeah.
Thank you
for everything you've done, man. And thank you for giving me a chance, taking a shot. Cause I,
absolutely.
I know you got the calls and I know it's like, yo, don't go up there.
Yeah.
They call it the bullpen for a reason. Cause they are vicious.
Yeah. Listen, I don't care what people say. I'm all about my people.
Right.
That's why I work so hard, because every day I go to work, I'm thinking about how I can best represent us.
Right.
So of course I was going to give you a shot. Like, why wouldn't I?
Right. Right. I know
listen,
you had to.
Listen, let me tell you, so many people have helped me. I can truly say, like, I'm not here because of anything I did by myself. So many people have helped me along the way. I'm talking about from college right through to this moment right now. Everything that I have achieved in my life is because somebody else helped me.
Right.
And I can never, ever not help somebody else.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I appreciate you, because they had wrote it off like, oh, you know, he's not, he won't come up there.
Nah, that ain't.
He won't. And I was like, yo, he's coming. And I had, you know, shout out to my girl Monique Moss, who want to take you out on a date, but that didn't work out.
How about somebody take me to lunch one day?
Mario, take Mario. Now, what is your favorite?
So my favorite, I love Sally's Pizza, and Cheesecake Factory is probably one of my favorite restaurants.
Yeah, Cheesecake Factory is a big deal.
One of my favorite restaurants. It's, you know, that's kind of small scale, but I love it. It's my favorite.
Yeah, everybody, Cheesecake Factory, Sally's Pizza, take them out. Y'all can sit down and
Sally's
chat.
Sally's Pizza, small potato, light baked.
Small potato, light baked.
That's
Sally's Pizza.
That's my official.
How much is that? What range of dollars is that in?
For a small, I think it's like $13. I don't even know.
Okay, yeah, that's doable. Yeah. Cheesecake Factory is reasonable also.
$20.
Yeah, you bring $20-$30, they can, you know,
a nice lunch for $20 at Cheesecake Factory.
Yeah. I like Cheesecake Factory. This, ladies and gentlemen, Mario is in the building. He came through. I appreciate him.
I appreciate everybody. I just want to, you know, as we close, I want to thank everybody in New Haven, West Haven, East Haven, everywhere I've been in Connecticut, Hartford. From the casinos to Greenwich. I mean, I've literally been all over the state. New Milford, every New London, every small town, every big town, every big city in the state, I've been there. And I want to thank everybody that has welcomed me. New Britain, Bloomfield. I had no idea it was so many Jamaicans in Bloomfield until I went there.
Wait, it is?
Yes.
I didn't know that either.
Bloomfield is like Little Jamaica. I had no idea.
Really?
Yes. So shouts out to Bloomfield, Windsor, Granby, all of these places that I've been. I never, ever dreamed I would be in Connecticut right now at this point in my life and would have a chance to go visit all of these towns and meet all of these people. So thank everybody. Everybody. Thank y'all.
Erica Fields says she's going to take you somewhere nice in a Cheesecake Factory.
Oh, okay.
Erica. He reach out and you guys can go. And you can't. I don't know if you're trying to make some kind of pass at him right now, but it's not happening, buddy. But
my social media for everybody is at Mario Boone TV.
Mario Boone TV. Definitely.
Facebook and Twitter at Mario Boone TV. And my email is MarioBooneTV@Yahoo. So that's my personal way to get in contact with me. If you're a source of mine, my cell phone number will not be assigned to me in a couple of weeks. So just be very careful about reaching out to me on the cell phone, because I don't want you to inadvertently expose who you are by hitting up that cell phone number. So if you have my cell phone number and you've been a source of mine, just hit me up on social media first before contacting me on that phone number, just to protect your identity.
Right. Mario, it's been a pleasure, brother. Everybody showed a lot of love. His phone is buzzing now. The phone is buzzing. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. It's the Raw Report.
Thank you.
We appreciate you.
Thank you.
We out of here. Good night.
Uh-huh.